Hey everyone, so today we're going to be doing a review of this Korean skincare line, Crave Beauty, and the two products we are going to go over are the Kalaluya Exfoliant and the Beach Shield Sunscreen. So let's get into the video. So the first product we're going to go over is the Kalaluya AHA Chemical Exfoliant, and this exfoliant is a gentle chemical exfoliant that gives sensitive skin types the chance and ability to actually try out chemical exfoliating without worrying about hurting their skin or getting oversensitized. For my top three ingredients, the first ingredient in here, of course, is going to be AHA. There's a 5.25% concentration of AHA in here, and that will help to remove dead skin cells. It's a little bit of a high concentration, but I've seen higher that are still at safe concentrations. So it'll help to remove dead skin cells, and then it'll also help to brighten the skin. The next ingredient I like is parsley, spinach, and kale. So those are all different ingredients, but they all fall under leafy greens, which have a really rich source of antioxidants and help with strengthening that skin barrier. The next ingredient I want to talk about is called panthenol. It's also known as vitamin B5. It's a really versatile ingredient that can be mixed with a lot of different ingredients and is just very formulation friendly. The other great thing about vitamin B5 or panthenol is that it's a humectant, so it's really good at holding moisture, and that's really beautiful in a formulation that is for chemical exfoliating, because usually chemical exfoliants don't focus on hydration, so that's what makes this so sensitive skin friendly. I have two concerns, and it's not concerns with this product, but it's more concerns with how people use it. This product has a pH between 3 to 4-ish, and that is very low. Now that's pretty normal because you have acids in here. It's a chemical exfoliant. You're not supposed to be a toner. But the problem is that people use this as a toner, which shouldn't be done because it will dry out the skin if you don't apply something else to tone, like a really thin serum or an actual toner or essence. The next concern that I have is people using this and then feeling tingling and thinking that it's not working or it's sensitizing your skin. Now, if your skin is like burning or if you have redness or breaking out from using this product, I would say maybe it's not for you, but tingling is completely normal when it comes to chemical exfoliation. It might not be present in chemical exfoliants that have a smaller concentration, like maybe in a toner, but when it comes to the actual just like plain exfoliant, it's most likely going to tingle, and that's okay. That is what chemical exfoliants are supposed to do. If I had to rate this, I would obviously give it a 5 out of 5 because it's probably one of my favorite chemical exfoliants to use for dry skin types. Now the next product is their Beach Shield. They luckily just came back in stock. I hope they're still in by the time this video comes out. This is a very lightweight sunscreen that applies like a serum to the skin. It has no white cast, doesn't smell like sunscreen, and just makes the process of applying sunscreen more enjoyable because it acts like a serum type of product. That's why I love applying it, and that's why it's probably one of my favorite sunscreens to use. So for the top three ingredients, the first ingredient is beetroot extract. And beetroot extract is a really good source of antioxidants. It's also known for helping to brighten and strengthen the skin, as well as to help reduce signs of aging. Next thing I want to talk about are UV filters. So basically what makes this different from other sunscreens is that it contains UV filters that are less sensitizing. A lot of UV filters in the US usually have that O in the beginning of their name. I believe one is like octocrylene. That's how you usually know what kind of UV filters are in your American sunscreens, but when it comes to sunscreens from Asia, this sunscreen contains different UV filters that aren't necessarily used or allowed in the US yet. They're just less sensitizing on the skin, and they have a higher chance of not degrading in sunlight exposure, so a lot of UV filters tend to degrade when exposed to sunlight, which is why you need to constantly reapply. So the UV filters that are in here, I'm going to read them off. I apologize if I cannot pronounce this right. Methoxyphenol triazine and ethylhexyl triazone. So those are just the two that I pulled out and that I figured were probably the filters. The last thing I want to talk about is macadamia seed oil. So the benefits of that are that macadamia seed oil is really high in fatty acids, so it's going to help really repair the lipid barrier and the skin barrier. No matter if you have oily skin or dry skin, most of the time if you're overproducing an oil, you probably have a damaged lipid barrier or very dehydrated hydrated skin underneath the surface because your skin is overproducing and overcompensating. So always using a product that has ingredients high in fatty acids is important for every skin type because it helps to repair your barrier and keep your skin very locked in and hydrated. So in terms of concerns for this one, there is alcohol and alcohol in a very high concentration. Now, usually I would not be touting a product that like contains a high concentration of alcohol, especially if it's very sensitizing on the skin. Personally, I felt no sensitization when using this, and I really love how Leah, the founder of Create Beauty, really goes deep down and explains why she used alcohol in this formulation, what its purpose is in the formulation, and then also she went through a clinical trial with a small test group to see if the alcohol or any of these ingredients would actually cause sensitization to the skin when people used it, and she found that there was no sign of sensitization, no sign of irritation. And the main reason she used alcohol in this formulation was to not mattify or rid of oil on the skin, but to help thin out that consistency to give you that serum-like feel and to also stabilize the UV filters, which are really, really important. So first, I would say if you have rosacea or really severe eczema, maybe you want to skip this just because of the alcohol and maybe you just have a really high chance of being sensitized. Second, a lot of brands won't tell you why they use ingredients and their purpose behind it. And I love how Leah was so transparent about that, and that honestly makes me feel more comfortable with using this product. So if you really want to give it a shot, I totally, totally recommend it because it's one of my favorite sunscreens to use. And I buy like 5 of them to actually wear on my freaking body when I go outside. I use this as a body sunscreen. So if I had to rate this product, I would give this a 5 out of 5. All right guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to check out these 2 videos on the end screen here, and I hope you really enjoyed. Bye.